Hi, we're Mark and Shauna, and this is the K-dip. The K-dip is usually done in either closed position or side-by-side position, and it's a great move because it's one of the few aerials that you can really lead, and the follow doesn't have to know what's going on at all.
It's sneaky. Step one is popping her up onto the leader's back.
For this aerial, you'll want to have a palm-to-palm hand connection because she's going to be pushing against you to keep up in the air. Before we get started, let's go over some fundamentals so you don't get hurt. First of all, as a leader, I want to lift with a nice wide stance. I don't want to have my legs close together and try and swing the follow around me. And I also want to make sure that I'm lifting with my legs and not with my back. That's also going to potentially cause injury. And the follower needs to also push down with this arm. Make sure that you're connecting really well here. As your feet leave the ground, if you don't, then he's going to be holding all your weight and there's potential that you might fall on the ground.
As a follower, I know when to start pushing with this hand. When he does this very first introduction, it's nice and strong, and when I feel that strong connection, I want to match it here with my hand. Normally, when we're dancing in this position, I'm going to stay loose because his hand here is nice and loose. But he'll make it clear to me when he starts the aerial, it's going to be a little bit stronger of a connection. And I'll match it. You see that? If you take other classes with Mark and I, you'll hear us talk a lot about matching. And this is one of those aerials where our entire body is matching that nice tight core. So Mark becomes tight here as he does a nice strong step in front of me. And I'll be strong here in my arm and strong in my core.
We're going to take a big step in front of our follower. We're going to get underneath her and then pop her up on your back. Step in front, big step. Crouch down, nice wide stance, and then get her up on your back.
And that pop really signifies to me, I gotta hang on and push here because something's coming. Step two is swinging the follow around onto his hip.
When you're ready to go on to the next step, go ahead and get to that position where she's on your back.
Pop.
And you're going to draw a circle with your hips, kind of like a hula hoop. And that will swing her around just like that.
As I'm swinging around, I make sure to push with my right arm so that I'm helping to support the dip.
One common mistake that we see with this aerial is that the follower won't keep her core tight and she'll let her legs be really floppy, and it can cause the aerial to be really, really difficult. Step three is swinging your follow out of the aerial.
Once Mark has me here, we have a good hand connection and I have a good connection on the shoulder. He's going to use his hips to swing me out and we'll land together. As I'm swinging out of this aerial, I'm pushing against Mark's hand so that I can get that distance I need to land.